of client services at Disha Communications Bangalore. He's been working in this marketing and advertising field for 40 years now. Initially, he used to do pharmaceutical marketing, marketing and advertising. And then he moved on to do set up a lot of ad agencies across the country like Everest Communications and Disha Communications. He's worked with Tata Motors, UB Air Taxi Services, which then became Kingfisher, and Toyota, State Bank, Weekender, Shell Petroleum, and many other liquor products. He's currently working on 15 CSR films for a bank. It's our pleasure to have you here, sir.
Thank you.
Now request you to.
Thank you very much. I suppose you can hear me. I have a small presentation, it's ready for. Let me do what advertising likes to do. Blow. It is so nice of Miss, what is the good name?
Milena.
Milena. Miss Milena to give me an introduction. Yes. I'm from Tamil Nadu, but settled now in Karnataka. And Bangalore has got one magnet. People who come to Bangalore would never like to leave the place. It has also happened to me. So now I'm settled. My wife is now working with BSNL. And I have a son who is with Citibank. My daughter just finished her graduation. And I have a very important person in my house. He is a golden retriever. He is my pet. And as I was telling her, I cannot stay without him for more than 2 days. Okay. So that's why I planned all my schedules of my film shoots, etc. Every week, 2-3 days like that. So I'll go and come back, go and come back kind of stuff. Now, can somebody tell me what is advertising? What is advertising? Promoting a product, yes. Dissemination of information to the customer, correct? Living.
Yeah.
Paid announcement. Yeah. Yeah, some more. See, basically, in advertising, please go by one. Nothing is wrong. Nothing is right. So whatever you told me, nothing is wrong. And in this condition, everything is right. Because at the last count, there are more than 600. It can range from awareness creation to increasing your sales, increasing awareness levels, increasing blocking competition, thwarting competition, forcing, creating demand, changing lifestyles, what you call instituting a thought process. So there are more than 625 reasons to advertise, right? That is why advertising has got one problem. They say 50% of advertising works. But which 50% works, nobody knows. Because we are dealing with the human mind. Okay, I'll say something which is already there in my presentation. When the power comes in, we'll run through it again. How do you advertise or what do you advertise? What will you decide? What are the thought processes in your mind?
Company.
Somebody? What thought process? She said company.
Electricity consumption.
Consumption. Price, quality, sir? Reviews and ratings.
That's
size, okay. Features, design. That. Come on, go on. After sales,
okay.
Offers, after sales service, colors. See, you will find what is happening is, when you want to buy a simple device, a cooling unit, buying a refrigerator, then you say company, color, space, features, electricity consumption, competition, door, the 2-door, 3-door, 4-door, no door, whatever it is. But the question is, do you company's name? So Saturday will decide what is going to be the. We don't like that. What actually is in your mind is, there are various factors which crosses your mind when you want to make a purchase. It can range from the company's name, it can range from competition success, and then he said ratings and ratings, what do you call window shopping, informed consultation with friends. Lot of things go through your mind, but they are not in a fixed order. For you, you can start with the color. For he, you can start with the space. For that guy, he can start with the size of the refrigerator, etc. Lot of things goes through your mind. Advertising, there is a timetable. Every individual has a timetable to make a purchase. A mental timetable. Advertising as a service or as a component or as a proponent intersects the timetable somewhere. For you, you will be see the ad of the refrigerator when you are thinking about color. For you, it will be when you are thinking about a company. Like that, so it intercepts the timetable, but not at a fixed space. That is why any product advertising has got three segments. One is called as the corporate phase. The corporate phase of advertising. Then comes the product phase of advertising. Then comes the after sales service phase of advertising. The three basic concepts of that. Who am I buying it from? I am buying it from Samsung. Who is Samsung? Samsung is a worldwide company, blah, blah, blah. They are electronics king. They are so Korean based, etc. Fantastic. Then comes the product phase. Yes, they have got single door refrigerator. They got a dual cone. They got a frost free. They have got a built-in freezer box. They got twin doors. They got double doors, shoulder doors, whatever you call them. So you talk about the product. And then comes 10 years of free service. Call this number if you have any problems. So the company has to say, you buy me, I am good, this is my product, and trust me because I will take care of you. That leads to two segments of advertising. Strategic advertising, one is called tactical advertising. Strategic advertising is what? Strategic advertising is nothing but saying that, please love me. Simple. I'm a good guy, please love me. That's what strategic advertising says. Tactical advertising says, love me later but buy me now. 2+1 free. You buy one refrigerator, I'll give you one radio free. You don't buy anything, I'll give you my visiting card free. Something. Get the damn thing out. This is tactical advertising. So, in a given market setup, you'll always find there's some kind of strategic advertising, there's some kind of tactical advertising. Now, since I'm talking to a Department of Electronic Media, where do you think you fit in? Do you fit in tactical advertising or do you fit in strategic advertising? You're sure? Then why are all the television shows say that buy me now and all this stuff? Why? What I'm trying to say is, any medium of advertising fits in both. For example, if I take, when will the power come? Any idea, sir?
I think maybe in 5 minutes.
5 minutes, because I have, this is very interesting slides I have got on those lines. Okay. Sorry, yeah? Because this will be more easy to understand for you. Magazines have the role play of what you call strategic advertising. Because when you say last 3 days, you can't put the ad in a magazine. Because magazine comes on Mondays, when you say last, next, if you see the ad after 10 days, your sale is already over. So the last 3 days doesn't have account. So magazines have a role playing strategic advertising. Whereas newspapers, you say last 3 days, they see it today, last 3 days, so today, tomorrow and day after. They have a role playing tactical advertising. Okay? That's how newspapers and in terms of media operations, it works out.